Welcome, metal fans, to Metal Evolution, the Albums, where we explore the records that have shaped the history of heavy metal. But these are not your dad's or your grandfather's metal albums. These are the records that are highly influential, yet severely underrated. And for this episode, we're exploring one of my all-time favorite records and one of the most important records in the history of extreme metal, and that's At the Gates, Slaughter of the Soul. To me, this record was just as big of a classic as an early Iron Maiden or Black Sabbath or Judas Priest album. And it came out at a very confusing time in metal because thrash was dead, death metal was getting redundant, grunge was huge, and new metal was on the horizon. So, thanks to the Swedish gods, this record, for many of us fans, saved the genre. I've traveled to Gothenburg, the mecca of Swedish metal, to meet with At the Gates. I've had the chance to interview the band before about the extreme metal scene, but this time I also get to see them play to a sold-out hometown crowd and really dig into the band's own story and how they made their masterpiece. I want to start in the early 90s, before Slaughter of the Soul. What was going on in metal at that time?
It was a pretty interesting time because everything that came out at that time felt like pretty fresh, apart from your old favorite bands like Maiden, who sounded probably their worst at that time.
I mean, death metal was 1991 in Sweden kind of exploding a lot when Morbid Angel came here to play, and a lot of bands came for the first time. And
we were very interested in death metal, but at the same time, we were very open-minded and trying a lot of stuff.
Yeah.
So within the creative side of us, it was very open.
Me and Anders listened to a lot of various stuff, like jazz, classical, and folk music even, and progressive music from the 70s.
And one important factor is that we were all beginners at the instruments.
Yeah.
So we didn't know how to play.
What was the response you were getting to those early records?
The diehard fans thought it was really cool because we were stretching the limits. But in general, people were not really getting what we were doing. It's like, you know, it's death metal. That's extreme in one sense. But then on top of that, they're also creating this mad progressive shit. And it really threw everybody off.
We wanted to achieve so much. There was like 200 riffs in each song.
Very yeah,
really
complex
yeah. Songwriting. And we wanted to impress everybody, you know, the world.
I want to jump forward. 1994, there's a tour where things really get fucked up. My understanding is you went out on a tour, and a few shows in, sort of everything collapsed.